So my mate lives out in the suburbs, and he doesn't think there's any point to living in the city. So let's prove him wrong. This is Kansas City, in one day. Start in River Market, always River Market. It's the oldest part of town, and each weekend it has one of the best farmers markets in the Midwest. Also, the skyline can't be beat from the north. No one ever thinks to go this far up, but you really get a feel for the industrialness.
Ooh, oranges.
See, that kid's digging it. But let's rewind. I fear I'm talking about places you don't know. Okay, I know you've never left Overland Park, so perhaps I should clarify. This is what Kansas City looks like according to Google Maps. But in reality, this rectangle is the core of the town. A 5-mile Paris of the Plains north to south strip. And it's got everything. So from River Market, we head to the Plaza for lunch. The entire place was based on Seville, Spain. And it does a pretty good job.
Cue the music.
It's got this fountain, and this fountain, and this fountain, and this fountain, and like 30 more. It's my favorite place to go for lunch, and probably one of the best architectural feats of planning for city shopping. You see, I like big cities. Big cities are so much more intimate than small towns. Emerson once said, cities give us collision. They take the nonsense out of a man. Yeah, word. Then, Nelson Atkins Museum. It's the one with the giant birdies you see online, and where everyone sunbathes topless. Well, sometimes. But it is entirely free, and has some bloody good art. I could go on and on about art. Good art should be accessible. It should say something about you and your life. And I know you think museums are elitist, but you living in Johnson County is kind of elitist. So go. You might learn something about the world we live in. Oh, so the Museum Cafe? Yeah, look at this place. It's better than the Guggenheim. After lunch in the Plaza and tea in Nam, go for dinner at Crown Center. Play in the fountains, see the big fish, explore Union Station. Have fun. Earlier I said big cities are more intimate. That's because in small towns, you know everyone. And it may not seem obvious, but when you grow up in a small place, you find there's intimacy in being in a sea of faces. It's like a party. The bigger the party, the more close-knit your small group becomes in it. And finally, I like to end the night in Power and Light. If you ignore the drunk hyena-like men, it can be pretty nice. It's a new district, a 5-block radius downtown, just rebuilt with a venue in the middle of it. It's lit up at night, and once you get into the city, you'll see what I'm always on about. That like art, cities reflect the people who create them. Cities should be accessible. And some smart people realize this. They're building. They built the Kauffman Center, Power and Light, Sprint Center, and the streetcars are coming. You see, KC has a population of about 500,000, but for its size, it's a jewel. The city grew up under the architect George Kessler. Because of it, it has quirks of beauty. A city is humans at their most ambitious. Build bigger, create more, sell harder, dream higher. At the end of the day, if you move out of the city, it means on some level you gave up. This is the town where Walt Disney honed his craft, and Hemingway worked right before Paris. This is a city of work, and to do well. You see, eventually the world breaks every city. But afterwards, many are strong at the broken places. And this city is one of them. So I guess three words, buddy. I'm sick of social graces.